Hello, welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to draw alkenes. The first question here says to draw the structure of 4-ethylheptene. The first thing we need to do is to look at the root here. And the root here says heptene. Hept means that there are seven carbons in this compound. So we draw out all the seven carbons. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Now, the next thing we look at is these two. These two here is telling us that at the second carbon, that is where the double bond is located. Okay. So if we count from this end, we have one, two. We'll put our double bond here. The next thing we look at is the substituent, which is this. We have 4-ethyl. 4-ethyl, the four here is telling us that the ethyl group is attached on the fourth carbon. So since we are counting from this end, this is one, two, three, and four. So at this place, this is where the ethyl group is attached. Okay, so after this, the next thing we need to do is to fill up all our hydrogen. Now, carbon has to have four bonds to complete its octet state. So you have one hydrogen here. That is one, two. We need two more to complete it. So this is what you have. For this place, you have one bond here already and two, so it only needs one hydrogen. This place you have one, two, three. It needs just one hydrogen, too. At this end, you have one, two, three, remaining one hydrogen to make it up four. Here you have this bond here and this bond. That is two. So we need two hydrogens to make up for this. So you have four complete bonds. For this one, you have one bond at this end, another bond at this end. You need two hydrogens to make it up four. This one has just one bond, meaning that it needs three more hydrogens to be complete. So with this, we have the structure of 4-ethylheptene. Heptene telling us that the double bond is at the second carbon, which is this, and 4-ethyl telling us that the ethyl group, which is this, is on the fourth carbon. If you are counting from the right-hand side, then your double bond would be at this end, and of course, this is also the fourth carbon if you are counting from here. So this is the structure for 4-ethylheptene. The second question says to draw the structure of 4,4-dimethyloctene. The first thing we also need to look at is this. Oct is telling us that there are eight carbons in this compound. So we draw out all the eight carbons. So we have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. We have the eight carbons. Now that we've written out all the carbons involved, the next thing is to look at which position is the double bond. Okay, we're dealing with alkenes, so there has to be at least one double bond somewhere, right? So which position is the double bond? From this name, it's telling us it's on the second carbon. So if we count from here, we have one, two. So we'll put our double bond here. The next thing is to look at all these other things in front here, which we call the substituents. where are they to be attached? So if we count, this says 4, 4, if we count 1, 2, 3, 4. On the fourth carbon, you have two methyl groups. That is why it is saying 4, 4 dimethyl, two methyl groups. So we add our methyl groups is CH3 and CH3. Okay, so now that we've taken care of that, the next thing is to fill up all our hydrogens. And in filling hydrogens, we need to remember that carbon has to be attached to four groups. Carbon has to have four bonds. So now that we know that, we count, this carbon here has just one. So it needs three hydrogens to complete its octet. So we have four. This is complete. This one has one, two, three. It needs one hydrogen to complete four. This here has one, two, three. It also needs just one hydrogen to complete four. Then we'll come here. This is already complete. We have one, two, three, four. So we don't need to look at that. We come here. We have one, two. It needs two hydrogen to be complete. Here we have one, two. It also needs two hydrogens to be complete. And here, one, two, same two hydrogens. And this one has just one bond, so it needs three hydrogens. So now this compound is completely drawn out. So you have your 4,4 dimethyl octuene structure. The third question says to draw the line structure of 2-ethyl-pentoneane. Now we're dealing with line structures. Here is telling us that we have the root as pentoneane. Pent is telling us we have five carbons, right? And when you are dealing with line structure, you will usually start with a dot, okay? Now this dot here is our first carbon. So we start, this is one, two, okay, three, four, five. So this is a very easy way for you to draw this out without making mistake, okay? So if we count this, we have one, two, three, four, five. So each of these represents carbon. So now we have this drawn out. It says that on the first carbon, that's where the double bond should be. So if I'm counting from here, I'll put my double bond on this part. If you're counting from this side, then it will be here, okay? I chose to count from here. Now with this, the next thing is to then look at this other part, which is the 2-ethyl, okay? Now the 2-ethyl is telling us that this is one, this is two. On the second carbon, you have an ethyl group. Now ethyl group in line structure is drawn this way. Now whenever you are trying to draw ethyl as a line structure, it will always be in this format, or it could face any way, but it will always be something like this. If it is a methyl group, it will just be one stroke. If it's propyl, you have three strokes like this joined together. Okay, and of course, they will always be attached to the parents wherever they are coming from. If this was the parent group, for example, it will be like this. Okay, so this is how you represent ethyl, methyl, and propyl in line structure. So we have our ethyl group attached at this end, coming out this way. It could face the other way. So we have 2-ethyl-pentoneane line structure. Fourth question says to draw the line structure of 4-ethyl-4,5-dimethyl-hept-1-ene. So we need to look at the root that was given, and this root here says hept one in. And it's telling us that there are seven carbons in this structure. So we start out by drawing our line structure from the first carbon, which I will represent as a dot here. One, two, okay, three, four, five, six, and seven. If we are to confirm that, that would be one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven.
From hept 1 in, we can see that the double bond is on carbon 1.
Now we have this. The next thing we need to do is to look at all the branches or the substituents. Now, the first one we can see here is 4-ethyl. It means that on the fourth carbon, you have an ethyl group. So we count 1, 2, 3, 4. This is our 4, and this is an ethyl group. Okay, so on 4-5, you have dimethyl. That means this same 4, you have a methyl group. Okay, and on the fifth one, you have another methyl group. So I'm going to put one of the methyl groups here. And on this other side, you also have one. So I'm going to rewrite this so as to position my methyl group. So if I have an ethyl group on this end like this, and I have a methyl group like that. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. On the fourth carbon, this is it, you have one ethyl group and one methyl group. And on the fifth carbon, which is this one, you have a methyl group. So this is a line structure for 4-ethyl, 4,5-dimethyl hept 1 in. Thank you for watching. If this tutorial has helped you in any way, please subscribe, like, and comment.